side action, and we're just about set to kick off. And now we bring you the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. The pregame festivities are over, and we're just about set to get this game underway. He just drills this one. And he's taken down at the 19-yard line. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. Nice run there. It's third down and 11 to go. Ball on their own 18. He wants it all, going long. Almost intercepted.
Defense does a really good job here of timing it up and knocking the ball away. I think they were anticipating pass on third down. And now we'll see what happens here on this big fourth down.
They're stacking the line. It looks like they're coming after this punt. The Cornhuskers offense basically predicated on what this kid can do.
The thing I love about this guy, Brad, is just the intangibles that he brings to the table. We've been seeing this guy make plays over the weeks, but the thing that I really recognize is his ability to really lead this football team. When things are going well, he's patting everybody on the back. When things are not going well, he's trying to pick them back up and getting them ready to go. So not only does he physically have the tools, but also I really love the way he approaches the game.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Gets rid of it quickly, and that was almost picked.
This is a very well-coached defense. They know to get their hands up in the air and to try to knock down passes.
Complete. He's taken down right around the 20. And a nice pickup there.
I'll tell you what, the defense gambled a bit here and came with the blitz. And a quarterback showed tremendous poise by making a good read and delivered a nice ball to the open man.
From the 20-yard line, first down. Tackle made right around the 4-yard line. That makes it first and goal. Get back to the line of scrimmage there on the option keeper. A loss of one. It's second and goal. Ball on the 5-yard line. The extra point. A 6-play, 41-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points. Nebraska kicked this one off. He'll return it from the one. Brought down at the 26-yard line. Nebraska is looking right now like they've got all three phases working for them so far, Kirk.
Yep, it's early, but they are in control of this game. The defense seems to have a very good feel for what they're doing out there. The offense moved the ball down the field. Special teams, everything right now is really in sync for this team.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Nice run, and he's brought down. He tackles him for a loss. Third and seven coming up here. Ball on the 29-yard line. Got it. Complete. He's out of bounds.
That is not easy to stop. The quarterback hit his man on an out route, and the defender was in man coverage. As a defender in man coverage, you cannot get beat deep. And as a result, the underneath routes are going to be there. And as you can see, it worked out great for the offense as they were looking for a new set of downs.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 37. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. Tackles him hard at the 45. So close, but they fall short of the first down.
You've got to throw the ball a little deeper next time. Don't take any chances of coming up short.
And this one is a beauty. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. We're about set to start things up again. Nebraska up 7 points. He's out to the 30. Makes it out to about the 39. So he keeps it and he gets a big first down.
The quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big game.
From their own 39-yard line, it's first down. Gains his way to the 49-yard line. That's a gain of 10 on the play. That'll make it second and inches. I'm coming. And they get nice yardage on that run. That's a gain of 6 on the play. First down. From the 45-yard line. First down. Complete. He's got room. And they make the stop at the 33-yard line.
Man, that is a great call and a big game, especially on an early down. That makes it first and 10.
Tackle at the 37-yard line.
There are a lot of players in the college game that can make something happen when the blocking breaks down. But when it's that bad, I don't care who you are, you're going down for a loss.
From the 37-yard line, second down. Fires to his tight end, nothing doing. Nebraska is up a score. There's a strike complete, and he's tackled around the 30-yard line. It looks like they're going to try for the long field goal. Nebraska can make this a two-possession game with this field goal. Kick is away. It's long enough, and he missed it off the upright.
Anybody who tells you that football isn't a game of inches might want to have a talk with this kicker. It doesn't get any closer than that.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Gets it. He's in space. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 40. After one, this game's still pretty close. Nebraska's lead is a touchdown. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. He's got it out to his tight end. He's tackled around the 42-yard line. Brought down around the 41-yard line. Bring him down around the 43-yard line. Throws incomplete, intended for his wideouts. It's away, and it's a booming punt. And he can't hang on to the ball. He just couldn't pull that one in clean.
And, Brad, that's what happens when you take your eyes off the ball. This was an error that should have been avoided.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Nebraska is up 7. And they got him for a loss.
Think about the speed and instincts it takes for a linebacker to get from his position into the backfield to make a play like that. That's well done.
They line up at the 8. Second down. Out of bounds at the 11. That brings us 3rd and 10.
Once and all, going deep.
And down he goes at the 36. Now it's 1st and 10 after the big pass play. Good outside run there.
That brings him 2nd and 5.
Man left, man left. Four down. Here we go. I got eight.
And he is drilled at the 22.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That makes it 1st and 10.
From the 22-yard line, 1st down. And he's taken down at the 20.
That makes it 2nd and 8.
Nebraska is up by a touchdown. They'll get him for a loss.
The defense had that one called perfectly. That's a big play on that loss.
That makes it 3rd and 11.
And here's another 3rd down. And
Touchdown, Cornhuskers. And he tacks on the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. They give to the tailback. He makes it to the 25-yard line. Makes it out to about the 43. Quick throw. He's taken down right around the 28-yard line.
He stood in there that time against the blitz. They were coming after him, but he showed the poise and was able to connect for a big gain.
Throws out and through his hands. From the 28-yard line, it's second down. Throws complete, and he's hit right away. Catches it, and he's looking for more. Runs through a defender, and he's in. That was a well-drawn-up play for the wideout.
Yeah, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
And it takes some real accuracy on those deep corner routes, so kudos to the quarterback. Hits the PAT. So that's a seven-play, 74-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown. So our score, 14-7. Southern Miss is ready to kick it away. He's to the 20. He makes it to the 25-yard line. The Cornhuskers, over the years, have had great quarterbacks. They've got another one. He's proving to be that here in the first half, and he's the true leader of this group right now.
Leadership. You hit the nail right on the head. This team is moving the football, but it has everything to do with this young man and what he's been able to do for them. Because, he's making great throws. He's making good checks at the line of scrimmage. But the thing that's standing out to me is his leadership and the way this team responds to that leadership, and that's why this team right now has played as well as they have.
It's first down and 10 now after picking up some great yardage through the air. Nebraska up 7 points. Gains his way to the 33-yard line. Nebraska is going to have to use their second time out of the half. He's going to try and scramble. And he's sacked.
Man, these guys can be aggressive. When you stand back there and take hits like that, you're definitely going to feel it the next day.
He scrambled. Now he's going to run and watch out. Tackle made at the 16-yard line. That makes it first and 10. Quick throw, tight end, touchdown. No, just like they draw it up, Kirk.
Yeah, Brad, you're exactly right. Offensive line did a good job of protecting the quarterback. Good route by the receivers. Results, touchdown.
He makes the PAT. They line up to kick this one away. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
This is my kind of game. We're getting a chance to see so many touchdowns. I just wonder if this offense could continue the flow that we've seen from the previous three series.
Last time out, they were able to pick up big chunks of yards through the air. You wonder if they'll go back to that same strategy, or will they start to lean a little bit more on their ground game?
And he just gets rid of it.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. From their own 27-yard line, third down. Well, we've played a half of football. Nebraska's lead is 2 touchdowns.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. So far, so good for both offenses in terms of taking care of the football, but now the defenses are ramping up the sense of urgency in terms of trying to get the ball back to their offense.
Absolutely. You got to find Reese. These ball hawks on defense, they need to find the football. They need to make some big plays, create some turnovers. How about using that hit stick a little bit? How about knocking somebody silly and making them drop the football? I mean, defense's number one priority is trying to turn the football over, try to make a big explosive play for your offense so they can do more damage and they can take the ball down the field. So those ball hawks need to show themselves in the second half.
Just about time to get you back out for the second half. Brad and Kirk will be along in just a second. You're looking forward to keeping an eye on everything around the country here. Got a good, like, good game score.
We're locked and loaded. We got all the big screens going. You're going to be looking to hand out some helmet stickers later. Yeah. We're loaded, man.
I'll try. You think you can keep on your shoes in the second half?
I'll try to. Are they stinky?
Yes. Brad and Kirk, you're at a safe distance. Take it away.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20, at the 30. They'll bring him down at the 44. We're about set to start things up again. Five wide. Gains his way to the 43-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 43. Nice run, and he's brought down.
Call it a gain of 6 yards. That'll make it second and 4.
Nice run there as they work the outside.
Call it a gain of 4 yards.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 33. He's out of bounds at the 33. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. He steps out at the 27-yard line. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about 4. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. That's a great tackle at the 16.
That makes it and 10.
The 10. He makes his way out to about the 6.
That's good for a gain of 10 yards. That'll make it second and inches.
This is the 8th play of this drive. They'll spread the field with 5 wide. And they'll get him in the backfield.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down. And knew exactly what to do with it.
They like the fact that they have a halfback who can pick his way so well through defenses.
And he adds the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. Down at the 26-yard line.
The Cornhuskers staff has got a winner on their hands. You've been around kids like this. They're just fun to be around.
They're fun to be around, and I think it's infectious. His attitude, I think, permeates throughout this entire offense and really throughout the entire team. It's no wonder this team is so competitive with him at the front leading the way.
Tackle around the 36-yard line. To about the 37-yard line. Throws it. And he stays in bounds and he hauls in a big one. Incomplete. He tried to hit his receiver in stride, but overthrew it a little too much.
That'll come in time. Just repetition, throwing that same pass over and over, and he'll be fine.
From the 37-yard line, it's second down. They keep it on the ground with a tailback. He gets out to about the 35-yard line.
That makes it 37.
To his receiver, and he's tackled around the 15-yard line.
That was actually pretty good defense, but a great pass and a great catch were enough to overcome it.
Gets it. He's in space. Steps out of bounds around the 14-yard line. They get nice yardage on that run.
That makes it 33.
He's in for the score, and they're back in it. Play ever developed nicely.
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
They call it a catch, but the booth signaled down to the referee that they'd like to take another peek at this.
Man, as I see this play again, it really looks like he made the correct call on the field.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
So the referee signals for a touchdown again. And he converts the extra point. Southern Miss kicked this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20, and he's taken down at the 23. Nebraska's offense has just been dominant here in the third quarter, and it's got to be pretty demoralizing for the defense.
Yeah, the defense, I mean, they just have to get some kind of stop here to be able to get some confidence and be able to get their own offense into a position and being able to put some points up. But right now, they just cannot stop this high-powered attack.
He's tackled at about the 25-yard line. It's second and eight. Ball on the 25-yard line. And they make the stop at the 33-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That'll bring up third and inches.
After a decent run up the gut. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 40. He's into the open field. Gains his way to the 46-yard line.
The 38-yard line.
Gaining eight on the play. That makes it second and two.
That's three down and one to go. Nebraska's in front by 14. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter.
The offensive coordinator has to be elated with the way his offense right now is executed. They're not in a hurry, but they're very, very methodical and very consistent with their approach. That's a third first down that they've picked up on this drive.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Here's the eighth play of the series. He's at the 20. Makes it out to about the 10. First down, 10 yards to go. 10 yards to the end zone. Catches it, and he's immediately tackled behind the line. That'll be a loss of one.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
Here's play number 10 on the drive. After positive yardage.
That'll bring up third and four.
And once again, they'll come to the line, try to convert on third down. Touchdown, Cornhuskers!
splits the uprights with the extra point. Nebraska ready to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Boy, the two offensive coordinators have to be loving this. In fact, you can look over at our booth next to us and see how much they're enjoying it with a big smile on their face. The defensive coordinators, on the other hand, might be looking for a pink slip on Monday.
They're ready to start another drive, hoping to duplicate the results of the last one, which ended in a touchdown. Throws complete, and he stopped immediately. There's a fumble. It's scooped up by the offense. And down he goes around the 25-yard line.
And they're lucky to retain possession of the ball there.
From their own 25-yard line, third down. He's going to go for the home run. And he got it. And he's level at the 20. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Deep ball, laying it out there. Incomplete, almost picked off. The offense took an errant shot into the end zone, and I'll tell you what, that one should have been picked off.
Yeah, I'm sure he's going to hear all about that from his teammates when he comes over to the sidelines.
Quick throw out to the receiver, and he's taken down at the 10.
I like the call here by the defense to bring the heat with the outside linebacker. It was just a better call by the offense, and that's why it's a first down.
There's a strike complete. Brought down right around the 6-yard line. That brings up second and goal. Fires quickly, and they got it. Touchdown. Tacks on the extra point. A 7-play, 74-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Brad, how about the guys up front? The offensive line giving the quarterback plenty of time to be able to read the defense and make the right throw.
They did a great job on their last drive, moving the ball down the field for a touchdown. Let's see if they can duplicate that on this drive.
I love to watch a quarterback when he can really get into sync with his wide receivers. These guys have worked all week on their preparation to attack this defense, and right now it's really paying off.
From their own 35-yard line, second down, a little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Made at the 48-yard line. And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. They come out in a 5-wide set. Setting up blockers or running backs. Got it on the screen. Good tackle there in space. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts. Flags are all over the place, and they'll blow it dead.
You got to be careful to avoid these. Penalties are a great way to stall out a drive.
So the penalty will make it first and 15. It out left to the running back. He's taken down around the 24-yard line.
Nothing flashy at all, but now that first down marker is a lot closer.
Throws this one out to the right. From the 24-yard line, third down. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Throws it to the end zone, touchdown. The huge pass and catch for the touchdown, and now we're down to a one-score game. And he hits the PAT. A seven-play, 69-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Brett, I thought the key to that drive really had a lot to do with the quarterback and the receivers getting in sync, making it very tough for the defense to slow him down.
He's tackled at the 43-yard line.
Brett, this is my kind of game. I love seeing this kind of production and the way these quarterbacks are playing. Both teams are challenging both of these defenses.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Just over a minute left. Gains his way to the 30-yard line.
When you're running the ball for big chunks of yards like that, you've got something working.
First and 10. Ball on the 30. He's at the 20. He makes his way to about the 18.
The offensive lineman played that one perfectly, giving the tailback plenty of space to work with, and he took advantage of it.
He makes his way out to about the 9. Great job by the running back, and that's a gain of 9. The Golden Eagles, they're going to have to call their third and final timeout. Run up the middle. Up by 7 and looking at first and goal. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. He takes the knee, looking to take some time off that clock. Cornhuskers know that they have to enjoy this guy while they've got him, because somewhere down the line he's going to be at the next level.
Well, that'll definitely be in his future, but for now he needs to sit back and just enjoy this performance, and really the play caller, the quarterback, the offensive line, the receivers, the entire group as just a whole should feel good about their performance.
That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.